possibly try to hold on to the White House here. But now we are going to go out to Nevada, where this is another highly contested battleground state. And we are now going to Fox's Robert Sherman, who is out in Las Vegas right now. Robert, as this is really something to see as the voting does continue, the counting does continue. But as we all know, Fox News Decision Desk has already called it for Biden there.
Yes, that's right. We're still seeing a few more ballots trickle in here in Nevada. What election officials say that they have to go through still so far, they have about 60,000 provisional votes that need to be evaluated and determine if the folks who did vote provisionally are eligible here to vote in Nevada. They're also waiting for a couple of ballots to be cured. That's really all that they're still waiting on here in Nevada, and they see no situation in which they wouldn't be ready in order to certify their votes November 16th. But we are tracking some other things here out of Nevada, namely allegations made by the Nevada GOP of voter fraud here in the state. And now new this week, there is a redacted affidavit which has been sent off to the Nevada Attorney General by someone claiming to be a whistleblowing poll worker. And in that affidavit, the poll worker alleges that there was a Biden-Harris bus parked at a polling center. And there at that polling center, the poll worker says that he or she saw workers opening up ballots and then submitting and filling out ballots. The Nevada GOP, the Nevada Attorney General at this point says that they have received this redacted affidavit, but they cannot act on it and investigate until they get some of that information that redacted information into their hands, namely the whistleblower's name and contact information. They do say that they do take all instances of and allegations of voter fraud very seriously. And so if and when they do have that information, they will be acting on it. Still, from local officials here in Clark County, and we always talk so much about Clark County here in Nevada, this is home to Las Vegas and over 70% of the state's population. Election officials here say that just about every instance or irregularity that they have seen and every allegation that has been made about voter fraud here, they have been able to investigate to a certain extent and come up with what they're calling reasonable explanations for things to be out of place. One example that they give is the Nevada GOP says has provided a list of over 3,000 names of folks who voted here in Nevada but appear to not live in Nevada. And the explanation that election officials gave there is that many of those names are military names. Many could be college students who may not at this moment reside in Nevada, but still maintain the legal right to vote in Nevada. That still has not stopped the Nevada GOP from continuing to hit this issue hard. We also have seen a couple of lawsuits filed here in Nevada. One was asking for the automatic signature verification process to be halted. That was the emergency response from a judge was thrown out in that case. We're also seeing a few other allegations of fraud here in the state, but the Attorney General has remained firm that they see no evidence of widespread voter fraud here in Nevada. New today, the president has taken to Twitter and he called the state of Nevada, quote, a cesspool of fake votes, and saying what his team is finding when released will be shocking. Back to you.
And Robert, last week and even over the weekend, we heard from President Trump campaign officials alleging of dead people in Nevada that were voting. Has any of those claims be substantiated? And is that something where they can look at obituaries and see if the names are cross-referenced?
Well, that continues to be an allegation made by the Nevada GOP down here, and we have seen reports circling of investigations into that. Nothing has been firmly confirmed at this point that this has happened, but again, it continues to be this conversation of the allegations swirling here in Nevada. And now we'll see as the courts, the Attorney General, the Nevada GOP, how this, how all these sides are going to clash over the next few days. But these all continue to be topics down here in Nevada, still waiting on a little bit more clarity on all of those.
And Robert, also with the timeline here, it has to move pretty fast there, because when the state certify that, I mean, that's going to be coming up on December 14th. So obviously we're looking at some time to have some sort of resolution before that, correct?
Right. So as we were talking about a little bit before, there's not many votes still to go through here in Nevada. Again, it's just a couple of ballots that need to be cured. The provisional ballots to go through, that's for the most part what is still on the table here in Nevada. But the deadlines for getting ballots cured is going to be November 12th. And then there will be canvassing on November 16th. They have seen a couple of ballots still come in through the mail. And remember, here in Nevada, ballots must be postmarked by Election Day in order for them to count here. Yesterday, that number was 24 ballots that came in through the United States Postal Service. So not really any more ballots coming in from that regard. It's just buttoning up the last few ballots that are in the system right now that still need to be evaluated and fully processed. That's what's left ahead. So the expectation from all local officials here is that they will meet their canvassing deadline of November 16th and proceed forward thereafter.
All right, Robert Sherman breaking it all down for us. All the happenings that are going on in Las Vegas and Nevada. Thank you so much for bringing us the very latest right here on News Now from Fox. We continue to roll on here in just a little bit, about 20 minutes. We will be getting an update in Pennsylvania as those countings still continue, even though the Fox News decision desk has called it for Joe Biden and ultimately the presidency for Joe Biden becoming the 46th president of the United States come January 20th there. So we will hear from Fox News's Katie Byrne coming up in about 20 minutes with an update there and the legal challenges for President Trump as well in that state. So we'll keep an eye on everything that is happening. You're watching News Now from Fox. Some of you are going to take a quick two-minute break. Stay right here with us. When we come back, we'll show you a little bit more of the updates coming out of Illinois regarding COVID-19. Another 10,000 cases as COVID-19 cases continue to surge in...